guys, just doing a little whiteboard training here, getting things set up. Here we go, a buyer's network versus a seller's network. I've actually been asked several times, you know, what's the difference? You know, why do some people go one way and other people go another? If you're gonna build a network of any kind, you kind of want to know the difference between a buyer's network and a seller's network. Now, there are certain things you're gonna have to do regardless if you build a buyer's network or a seller's network, and I just want to make sure everybody's clear that you're gonna have to do some basic things. First of all, you're gonna have to learn how to contact, you're gonna have to learn how to invite, you're also gonna have to learn how to present whatever your product or opportunity is. That's a must. Follow-up, you're gonna have to do some follow-up. Counsel, you're probably gonna need some specific training, people are gonna ask you questions, so you're gonna have to know how to answer that in an intelligent way that actually convinces people that you're probably the right person to sign up with. Questions and answers, you know, you have to sound knowledgeable, you have to know the game, you have to know how it's played, you have to know who's in it, those kind of things. Eventually, you're gonna have to sign people up. You're gonna have to put pen to paper or go on the computer and physically app people up, sign them up, get them in, whatever you wanna call that. And last but not least, you're gonna have to be able to get them started. If you don't know how to get people started, that's another skill. So whether you build a buyer's network or a seller's network, you're gonna have to do these things. But my background is actually real estate. And one of the things when you go in to buy an investment property is you don't really look at the initial, you look at the end. You know, what is the exit strategy? And if you talk to any financial planner that I know of, they kind of look at the end. You know, let's say by the age of this, what do we want to have net? And what I would ask you is if you're going to build your network marketing company or network marketing business, you know, because it is your business within inside a business, you know, you do it by yourself, but not, you know, completely by yourself, you're going to want to know these things. So I want to just show you a quick example of the difference of why, you know, I built in both and why I chose a buyer's network is a much smarter idea. So the easiest way to do this is draw an example. We're going to put buyer's network on the left, and I apologize, my writing's terrible, and seller's network on the other side. And I'm going to start with the seller. Here's basically how it works. Let's say you go out month one, and you're going to go out and let's say you're going to sell whatever or app up whatever, you know, you're marketing on a seller's network. Now, I personally was involved in a company where we sold a legal service and an identity theft. So that's the service industry that I was in. It was a seller's network. We got paid pretty good. And to actually achieve the top level or an executive level where you started getting paid some good money, you actually had to hit 50, well, it was 75, but they changed it to 50, so we'll just use 50 as an example. You had to hit 50 sales, and what that did is the following month, so month two, you were paid as an executive. Now here's the interesting thing. In a seller's network, what I had to do, or what, you know, most people have to do, I had to do, you actually have to go out and sell 50, watch this, new people on the book. Now the interesting thing is to stay an executive, the third month, guess what you have to do? Again, to stay executive in the company, you had to send 50 new people again. Well, if you calculate this out for a year, take 50 times 12, what does that equal? Well, it's going to be 50, you know, that's 500, it's going to be 600 brand new people that you and your team is going to have to find to actually build a network. And here's the interesting thing, if you found all 60, at the end of the year and you're still doing 50, you're literally making the exact same amount minus whoever quit. Now, on both sides, both the seller's network and the buyer's network, you are going to have people who aren't going to follow through, they're not going to do it, they're going to talk to their grandma, they're going to talk to their broke uncle, they're going to talk to their dog, they're going to pray about it, they're not going to pray about it, they're going to go to sleep, they're going to trip, their car's going to break down, they don't even have a car, it's going to say, it's not my cup of tea, they don't even drink tea, I mean, there's just going to be issues and they're not going to do it. But the buyer's network, here's why I chose a buyer's network rather. If you look at a buyer's network, and let's say we're going to go out and do the same work, we're just going to go out and find 50 people to buy. So I go out and I find 50 people to buy, that's month one. Now, the interesting thing is if I do the exact same thing the next month, now this is where it's pretty cool. If I go out and actually find 50 new people, just like I had to do here, I get to add those to the other, and now I'm paid off of 100 people buying. Over here, I'm paid off of 50 people buying minus the people quit. Now, could people quit here? Yeah, but let's just call this 45. What would you rather be at? This is a math question. What would you rather be at? 95 people paid off of or 50? Now, this is where it gets crazy. Let's say month three. Well, month three, let's use the example of 100. We had 100 people, and we add another 50. Now we're at 150. And by the end of the year, here's the difference. We're basically going to be at 600 people. But here's the difference. I would be paid off of 600 people. A seller's network, I would have gotten paid off of 50 people. This is called making money, and this is called getting screwed. So that's my whiteboard training. I hope you got something out of this. I hope you can use this, you know, for a training or maybe somebody that, you know, is looking at both sides, trying to see which, you know, company that they want to go with or which example. And, you know, I happen to sell this, but there's a bunch of companies out there that are more sellers networks, meaning every month you have to find brand new people. I mean, there's adult toy companies. There's, you know, a good example, usually a jewelry company, bag companies. They're set up for a party, the next party, and you just sell. But on the back end, there's really no residual because it's always brand new people, brand new people, brand new people, and you kind of run this scenario. Now, can you build a bigger team and sell more? Yes, but it's sales, sell, 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 sell. Here, it's just customer acquisition, buy, 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 buy. In the end, if you look at the top companies of all time, the top companies of all time fall right here. Now, there's a lot of companies who start here and make a lot of money. There's a lot of money to be made. But in the end, if you look at the end game, where would you rather end up? Why are you doing what you're doing? If you're doing it for a residual income, the residual income is here, not here. So I hope that helps. Thanks, guys.